Somebody, when he first got here, he just an old country boy. He hit it just as hard as he could go, right over there. He visits with us. This is about, what, the third or fourth time, Wayne, we've had you here. A fine country entertainer, a fine country songwriter, and a great guitar player. And I'd like for you to folks to give a great big Green County 4th of July welcome to Wayne Kemp.
Thank you.
I feel juice well enough going deep inside, like my heart's from a big break. And the stab of lonely is short but painful, and I might never shake. Well, you might say that I was taking it hard, that you wrote me off with a call. But don't you wait to let it happen.
And it's good to be back again. Thank you, Wendell, for having us back. We have a good time.
Who's that old hairy-legged boy right yonder by that tree?
I don't know. It looks like David. No, that's not David. That's that other boy. Lonzo, ain't it? I never know which one he is. But he's the other half of the Lonzo and Oscar team, that's for sure. And they're two of the best little boys in the world. We know. Because we give them rides all the time when we're touring. They're always hitchhiking. They got one of them Japanese trucks, too. Whoopee! We got red eyes on, didn't we, Pat? We got us Ford. Gosh, mighty. We ain't broke down since, have we? We drove it up here today, made it all the way. Didn't have one breakdown. We're going to go back and get some of the songs that we've written for other people down through the years. We'll start with a song I wrote for Conway Twitty back in 1922. That's how old Conway is. I wouldn't tell on myself at all. See, I wrote it. 32 years before I was born. Maybe y'all remember, it goes like this. Yes, I know she's the life of the party. And without her, things here would die. Oh, but don't you be fooled by her laughter. She has her sad times. She knows how to cry. Now she drinks and she talks just a little too loud. With her pride gone, she tags along with any old crowd. I know I'm to blame,
shame that I made her the image of me. Years ago, God, I'm the only hill my mom ever tried to raise. Well, I can't sell my mama showed on loving me. Guess that's why she let me go so far. Short of stealing, guess that's why I had to steal that car. Mama told me not to smoke it, but it made me fly and it took me far away. Then I turned out to be the only hell my mama ever tried to raise. Store went down. Now I sing precious memories, take me back to them good old days. Let me hear my mama singing, rock the pages clip for me. She tried to turn me on to Jesus, but I turned on to the devil's way.
way. And I turned out to be the only help my mama ever tried to raise.
We need a cup of water up here right fast. He swallowed a bug and he said he wouldn't walk down.
That's it. I got a frog in my throat and crossed its legs, hooked its toenails. Might take some white lightning to get this booger down. Yeah, he'll have to walk down like everybody else. There we go.
Better smell of that.
That's that river stuff there.
Not, I bet I could find that and just show me a river bank, go down and I'll find it. It'll do her every time. My wife won't let me drink, Patsy. She won't let me drink none of it. We've been married 25 years. We're celebrating my anniversary. 24 years, huh? I'm hurrying it up a little bit.
Have the little lady to step out there, Wayne. Step up.
I don't know if she can get up or not. She's bashful. She's one of them hill girls. Don't let them sunglasses fool you. She bought them in town. That's the first pair she's ever seen. She's been trying to commit suicide lately. She's been despondent as heck, you know. After you're married 25 years, they kind of turn on you. I've been giving her a hard time. She's failed it 3 times. Finally sent her over my psychiatrist the other day. He told her how to do it. Just get your 357 Magnum, put it 1 inch below your left breast and pull the trigger. Do it every time. She did it. She went home, done that, and blowed her kneecap off. She's been limping for about a week now. I sold a gun after that. I better sing a song before I get out of that, because I'm in trouble, I can tell. I'm going to dedicate my new record to her, because I wrote for her to go, "Don't send me no angels, Lord, because I got one of my own." When the storm clouds gather and I'm losing my way, she stands right. She lights up my day. She's the one thing that I've done right my whole life long. She's the words and the music to the world's finest song. Calling me home. Don't send me no angels, Lord, I've got my own. Still going on. That old feeling between us is still coming on strong. When my eyes close forever and my last breath is gone, don't send me no angels, Lord. I promise I'll love her.
till I walk my last mile. When my eyes close forever and my last breath is gone, don't send me no angel, Lord, I've got my own. If I make it to heaven, can I bring her along? Don't send me no angels, Lord, I've got my own.
Lord, you know what's it. Thank you very much. I'm going to sing a song. I wrote this song for Johnny Cash a few years ago. It's the only song I ever wrote that made an automobile out of. Most of mine are dogs. This turned out to be a car. If you ever get a chance to go to Nashville, go by the House of Cash Museum, you'll see this ugly car. This is where it come from, because I got an ugly mind. It's an ugly mind to write something that they can make a car out of that. It goes like this here. Maybe you'll recognize it, called One Little Piece at a Time. Well, I left Kentucky back in 49. I went to Detroit working on assembly line. And the first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillac. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, cause I've always wanted to be one that was long and black. And one day I'd derive myself a plan that ought to be the envy of the working man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. And getting caught meant getting far, but I'd figure to have it all with the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. And I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild. I'm not the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox and the hip of my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gears. Now, I've never considered myself a thief, but General Motors wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. So the first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I ripped off an engine and a trunk, and then I stole me a transmission and all of the chrome. The little stuff I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, but the big stuff we snuck out in my buddy's mobile home. That's what you do when you forget the words. Up there, everything been going all right till we tried to put it together one night, and that's when we noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53, the motor turned out to be a 63. We tried to put in the bolts, all the holes was gone. But we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with just a little hip of made after kit, we had that engine running just like a song. Now the headlights, they was a hell of a sight. We had one on the left and two on the right, but we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. Now the back end looked kind of dumb too, but we throwed it together, and when we got through, that's when they noticed that we only had one tail fin. And about that time, my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts. But she opened the door and said, honey, take me for a spin. Well, we drove it uptown just to get the tags, and just for hell, we made the main drag, and I could hear everybody laughing for blocks around. But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, because the type had up and took the whole dang staff, and by the time they got through, the title weighed 75 pounds. And I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, cause I got the only one there is around. I say, Breaker, that there Red Rider, you got a copy on the Pack Rat. Bring it back. I say, Red Rider, this here is the Pack Rat you got on the radio. Haul. Negatory on the cost of this here machine, Red Rider. We went right up to the factory and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. But it's a 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59 automobile. Well, it's a 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70 automobile. Thank you for that sympathy. That's a long booger. We're going to go back. We met a lady a while ago. Remember one of our records from way back yonder called Listen. And we're out for the Decca record label. Go like this here. Listen to a broken heart. Trying hard to be. Listen to the sounds it makes when it shatters at your feet. Listen to the crying sobs of broken, beaten food. Listen, that's one thing I didn't do. You warned me so many times, but I didn't hear. Why did I look around for love when I had so much love so near? Over and over, you told me you would leave me someday. But sweetheart, I didn't listen to a word you had to say. Listen to a broken heart, trying hard to beat. Listen to the sound it makes when it shatters at your feet. Listen to the crying sobs of a broken, beaten fool. Listen, that's one thing I didn't do.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We're going to sing a new song. It's a brand new song. Y'all ain't heard it yet. But George Donald.
He does that every time he comes here. He uses us for the guineas.
For rehearsals. I probably won't never sing it. George Jones already sung his song. I wrote it for him the other day. He said, write me a song about Tammy. He was feeling pretty good, you know. He wouldn't have said something like that. But I took him serious. I went home and wrote it. Took it back and he recorded it. Goes like this here. I woke up downtown again in jail this morning. They say that I went crazy from drinking booze. Then they hit me one more time for no reason. But they can't hurt me, not half as much as you. Must have walked across my mind again. I don't recall what I've done or where I've been. I was holding my own. Then everything went wrong. You must have walked across my mind again. That old jukebox won't be playing our favorite song anymore. Damaged everything I laid my hands upon. And that one old boy might not make it through the night. You must have walked across my mind again. Just what I've done or where I have been. I was holding my own. Then everything went wrong. You must have walked across my mind again. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, I hope y'all probably hear that on radio pretty soon.
Right there he sits. He's kind of hid behind the tree, but...
Who's that?
The radio right there.
Oh, well, good. Play that for old George. Play George's record. Me and him both need the money. I need it worse than he does. He throws it away. But we love it. He got me started in this business many years ago. Let me play guitar for him, and that started it all off. Give me a job, $35 a week. Patsy remembers that. She didn't have enough money to cook. And we went all over everywhere, the world, too. You don't do anything getting the music business, folks, I tell you. Because we got fired 8 times a week. They always hired us back next morning, though. Every time. We still love him. We wrote the very first song, number one song we ever wrote. George Jones recorded it for us. Got us into the writing business also. Maybe y'all remember it called Little Bitty Teeny Anything Called a Love Plug.
Yeah! Which glass is right?
Get that frog on down there. Are y'all having a good time? My gosh, you ain't got no sun bearing down on your head. God kept his little spotlight in today, didn't he, for a little bit. Give you a break. But it's supposed to just pour down rain about 5 minutes. Now, we're not ready. We don't want to do that just yet. Maybe a drop or two, you know, just cool things off.
Did a pretty good job right here on stage.
I know some girl come up here and took a picture of a waterfall a while ago. My gosh. Just like Elvis. Yeah, I don't know why he carried that tail. I never did know that. Scarf? Oh, he had one of them silk scarves. I can't afford one of them towels all I can afford. Probably had diamonds dripping off the end of it, too. One of the very first songs I recorded for the Decca label was called I Wonder Who Will Turn Out to Last. I wonder who. In your world tonight, whose shoulder will your head be resting on? Does your hungry arms reach for a man you feel you need? Will the need still be there after he's gone? For the switch that turns out my lights, I wonder who'll turn out the lights in your world tonight. Has someone found the secrets that I could never find? Is he touching that old switch that I've touched so many times? Is he turning on the woman that I could never satisfy? I wonder who'll turn out the lights in your world tonight. Thank you. is he touching that old switch that I've touched so many times? Is he turning on the woman I could never satisfy? I wonder who'll turn out the light in your world tonight. Do what? Oh, your wife's been cheating on us again. I'm glad you remember reminded me of that. I forgot it. This is a song I wrote, especially for old Eubanks over here. Called Your Old Lady Is Cheating On Us Some More. It's close enough, man. But I followed your wife and another cowboy to every honky-tonk in town. Now we
been. How about it for Wayne Kemp to see that? A great big hand.
Me and her been pretty close, ain't nothing I wouldn't do for you. But your wife is cheating on us again. What's mine is mine and what's yours is mine, that's the way it's always been. Your wife is cheating on us again. Now, old buddy, you can be just a little better sport about this. Poor old eyes is a-getting sore from pounding on your fist. So let's shake hands and call it quits and go kick in a cowboy's door. We'll show him a thing or two if you let me off with this floor. Your wife is cheating on us again. What's mine is mine and what's yours is mine, that's the way it's always been. Yeah, old buddy, if you'll just let go of that scissor lock you got around my throat, I'll go get that address out of that shirt pocket that you just ripped off of me. As soon as I find the rest of that ear that you bit off, we're gonna go over and find that cowboy and do him in. You are gonna help me, ain't you? Figured you would. You've always been a friend. I'll buy the bed. Still ain't going out. Your wife is cheating on us again. What's mine is mine and what's yours is mine, that's the way it's always been. If you don't help me straighten her out, we ain't gonna stay friends. Your wife is cheating on us again. Your old lady is cheating on us again. Do a couple more songs here. We got Lonnie's on Oscar. I got entertainment going on all day, way into the night too tonight. We got another show. We're gonna do another show later on, but we'll give y'all a chance to hear everybody. Today's a bunch of us. We're all having a good time. It's fun out here today. You know? Yeah, yeah, yeah. I went down through there looking around trying to find something to buy, and Patsy wasn't getting no money. I found two or three things that she wouldn't let me have. Uh-oh. Okay, darling, I'll be ready about midnight now. I'm enjoying singing today. Okay. Gosh, I'm on your side. How old? 69. Today your birthday?
Everybody holler happy birthday, right? Happy birthday.
Well, I'll be darned. We're glad to have you out here today. Are you enjoying music? You like country music? Well, all right. You found the right place today. Okay, here we go, here we go. We're going to do another song for you. I forgot what was. Had it all picked out. Oh, I know what it was now. I promised this young lady back here I'd do it. We'll do it for you, too, because it's...
Wayne, did you ever get Dolly's bus fixed up?
No, I didn't. Sure did.
You're still in the body shop business, aren't you?
Yeah, I still got a body shop. Yeah.
Before you get off here, let's work on that bus a little.
Okay. Well, you can't really, because, you know, the back seat's terrible. It's got them two big holes back there where you've been laying on her stomach. We'll have to get somebody in the poster business to fix that. I don't think you could beat that out with a hammer. Sure don't, huh? I'll do this song right here for you called Darling that we recorded. First song with a gospel song I wrote with Conway Twitty that's on his one of his gospel albums. Kind of the way I was raised in this old church house. I kind of wrote down how I feel. It's called Me and My Neighbor.
neighbors say. That other church across the street, well, it don't belong today. Well, they screaming and shouting, they carry on like the world's gonna end. Then I saw him stand in silence when the sermon began. Well, I met my neighbor, stood and listened. While the power of God filled the hearts of everyone. Well, it was my neighbor who nailed and prayed. Well, it was my neighbor that shouted louder than anyone.
Have you enjoyed Wayne Kemp this verse? Give him a great big hand. Fine job, Wayne.
It might have been a little old-fashioned, but it done us all some good. I won't forget that Sunday when God filled the neighborhood. It might have been a little old-fashioned, but it done us all some good. It was me and my neighbor who nailed and prayed. While the power of God filled the hearts of everyone. It was me and my neighbor who stood and listened. It was me and my neighbor that shouted louder than anyone. It was me and my neighbor that shouted louder than anyone.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it. We got another show to do in a little while, so don't anybody run off. We shall return. We got Lonzo Mosher coming up here very shortly, so stay around.
You gonna let him get away? Hey, how about a great big hand for Wayne Kemp?
I just stood there and listened. I could not turn away. Everybody in the neighborhood, well, they all came in to pray. Well, I won't forget that Sunday when God filled the neighborhood. It might have been a little old-fashioned, but it done us all some good. It was me and my neighbor who stood and listened. While the power of God filled the hearts of everyone. It was me and my neighbor who knelt and prayed. It was me and my neighbor that shouted louder than anyone. It was me and my neighbor that shouted louder than anyone.
Job. Wayne Kemp, Mercury Recording star, Decca Records, new song out. Ray, don't, that's right. You give me that mental lamp. Don't send me no angels. I got mine on. Bring the box over.
Thank you.
everybody ready to get back to their seat? We've got an old boy on stage that the country music makers, I believe this is your fifth time here, Wayne, right? We haven't paid you yet. But I'll tell you what, son, if you keep improving, we're going to try to work out something with you for long. He writes one of the finest country songs that's put on records. He's wrote 100 of them, I guess, that's made the charts, and 100 more that he still wants somebody to pick up. The one I sung, I told you, was 14 years old, and then it picked it up again. I want you to give him a great big hand. How about it for Wayne Kemp? Wayne?
Back here. We love to be around people that love country music. There's more folks up around here that love country music than any place I've ever been, I guess. We got rain last time. I remember it. Rain cast and all about that. 4th of July last year.
Sure did.
And everybody was hiding under the trees. And the lightning would strike the tree and running out under the tree. The only place to go was underneath the tree. There's lightning everywhere out there. I was afraid. And I was 100 yards from the tree. This could be back again. It's dry in here. That first song I just sung here, I wrote that thing for George Strait. It's a brand new song. It's out now playing. One of overnight successes. I wrote it almost 11 years ago. So anybody that wants to be a songwriter, be patient. It takes a while sometimes. We're going to go back and get some of her older songs down through the years that was written for other people. Maybe you'll recognize some of them. Here's one I wrote to Conway Twitty called "I Made Her the Image of Me."
Yeah. Yes, I know she, the life of the party.
Brand new song. This my son first has been saying it up here every time I come. Been saying it finally got recorded. I'm gonna sing one that got recorded before I come. Last time took a long time. But this one, we wrote this one this year a while back, and George Jones recorded. You probably will never hear it. Probably another 10 years. But they don't tell you what they're gonna do with these things. They say, well, we recorded it. You say, when's it coming out? I don't know. Better call me next year or something. It might be out. It might not be. It might be out next month. You can't ever tell. We're going to sing it anyway. Kind of give you a preview of it. Me and my wife, Pat, wrote this song. And Pat's the one gave me an idea for it. Tell so much for the good girls. I've had enough.
She said if you come on drunk anymore, there'd be some more songs.
I did that the other night. I come up there, knock on the door, and shut the door, and says, drunk again. I said, oh, I come in this summer. If you ever get in here, well, this thing's called So Much for the Good Girl, it goes like it. Well, that fork is green.
my first fear when she walked through the door. She said, I love you, honey. Then she picked up my money and left me a five and she walked out the door. So much for the good girls, every damn one in this world. I might as well face it just like I can have. She don't like the pressure. She does all the thinking. So much for the good girls, fine, I'll just go back. Heard this yet. They're catching up on it. Oh, Johnny Cash does that paper hits. Till death do us part is what I heard her say. I can feel the grim reaper coming in my way. You better put down that sickle. He's gonna need him more than I can drink me more whiskey than anyone can. Well, the bartender said, you better down that last beer. Take that girl somewhere that you can't stay here. So I called us a taxi, then we run out of the. When we checked in the motel, I set my own truck. So much for the good girl, never than one in this world. Might as well face it, looks like I've been had. While I was out playing, she wasn't home praying. So much for the good girls, looks like she's gone bad. Thank you. We promised the gentleman we'd do this one of our records that we're recording. Don't send me no angels. We'll go right here. When the storms and clouds gather, and I'm losing my way. She stands right beside me. She lights up my day. She's the one thing I've done right my whole life long. She's the words and the music to the world's finest song. Lord, let me keep her at least for a while. I promise I'll love her till I walk my final mile. When your trumpets are sounding and you're calling me home, don't send me no. Lord, I've got my own. She stayed with me through the hard times that's still going on. That old feeling between us is still coming on strong. When my eyes close forever and my last breath is gone, don't send me no angel. Lord, I've got my own. Trumpets are sounding and you're calling me home. Don't send me no angels, 'cause I've got my own. If I make it to heaven, can I bring her along? Don't send me no angels, Lord, I've got my own.
Thank you very much. You giving up? Hey, you know how breakdancing was invented? You ever see that breakdancing? Where they get on their back and spin and all that stuff? They found out where to come from. Stealing hubcaps off a Cadillac at 80 miles an hour. That's where it comes from. Here's a song. I'm going to do this for Wendell. That one time, Curtis Wayne was here with me. The first time I was here, Curtis was working with me. I recorded his thing. Curtis sung with him. Maybe he remember how to do it. It's called Your Wife's Cheating on Us Again.
Now we've been friends since the end, then that's the least that I could do. Me and her's been pretty dang close, and it nothing would do for you. But your wife is cheating on us again. What's mine is mine, what's yours is mine, that's the way it's always been. If you don't help me straighten her out, we ain't gonna stay friends. Your wife is cheating on us again. Sport about this. My poor old wife is a getting sore from pounding on your fist. So let's take hands and call it quits and go kicking that cowboy's door. We'll show him a thing or two if you let me off of this floor. But your wife is cheating on us again. What's mine is mine and what's yours is mine. That's the way it's always been. If you don't help me sleep for now, we ain't gonna stay friends. You might be cheating on us again. Yeah, old buddy, if you'll just let go of that scissor lock you got around my throat, I'll go get that address out of that shirt pocket that you just ripped off of me. As soon as I find the rest of that ear that you bit off, we're gonna get a six-pack of beer and go over and hook that old cowboy. Y'all gonna help me. But your wife is cheating on us again. What's mine is mine, what's yours is mine, that's the way it's always been. If you don't help me straighten it out, we ain't gonna stay friends. Your wife is cheating on us again. Your old lady is cheating on us again.
Thank you, gentlemen. Boy, that played good tonight. Some of these songs I ain't never heard before. We didn't have time to rehearse them. Oh, where'd you go? Oh, those old boys. Sorry about that. And old gals, too, back here. Never seen an old gal in my life. You sitting awful close to her, boy. Vernon, she turned around there and knocked me from my chair. Man. Snaps me twice a day to get my attention. She drives a lot on the road. I'll be back. I'll be over sleeping and she'll just reach over and box the heck out of me and say, what am I going to do now? Rhett's fixing to happen. Look what's coming up. No, wait, man. Go ahead and do it. I won't know about it. She's a good one. I'll let her drive in the mountains because it fits her driving. She gets on level ground and it ain't too good. But she's a good old gal. Been married to her 26 years now. And she is. We're kind of proud of her. She keeps us out of trouble. Look at all the wives and kids I'd have now if it wasn't for her. All that alimony. Child support. It's all fun, business. Not really, we're just kidding. We wouldn't take nothing for it. That's true. I'll go. We're going to do a song. That I wrote this song with Johnny Cash, and they made an automobile out of it. It's the only song I ever wrote. They made a car out of it. Close my song, Your Dogs. It doesn't turn out to be a car. If you ever go to Nashville, go to the House of Cash and probably see it sitting out there in front of the museum. On one piece at a time. Back in 49, I went to Detroit working on assembly line. First year they had me put wheels on Cadillac. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by. Sometimes I'd hang my head in the crowd. I've always wanted to be one that was long and black. One day I'd derive myself a friend that ought to be the envy of the working man. I'd speak it out here in a lunchbox in my hand. Getting caught meant getting far, but I figured to have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. And I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride a family style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild. Cause I got the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in my big lunchbox and the help of a friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gears. Now I've never considered myself a thief, but General Motors wouldn't miss this one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. So the first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, and then I ripped off a transmission and all of the chrome. The little stuff I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, mixed up, we snuck out my buddy's mobile home. Up to there, everything was going all right till we tried to put it together one night, and that's when we noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53, the motor turned out to be a 63. We tried to put in the bolts, all the holes was gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit with just a little help from a doctor kit. We had that engine running just like a song. Now the headlights, they was a heck on the side. We had one on the left and two on the right. We pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. Now the back end looked kind of crazy too, but we floated together, and when we got through, that's when I noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts. She opened the door and said, honey, take me for a spin. So we drove to town just to get the tabs, and just for heck, we made the main drag. I could hear everybody laughing through blocks around. But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, because to top it up, it took the whole dang staff of time. We got through the tidal weight, 85 pounds. And I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll always see when I come to your town. I'm gonna ride a thousand style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild. Cause I got the only one there is around. I said, bring it to that there Red Rider. You got a copy on the pack rat, bring it back. I said, Red Rider, this is the pack rat. Paul. Now got tore on the coffin this here old machine, Red Rider. We went right up to the factory and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? Now let me look on the title. Page 132. But it's 49.50, baby, one baby, two baby, three baby, four baby, five baby, six baby, seven baby, eight baby, nine baby, $10. Well, that's 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, automobile. Say it now because everybody's against Air Force selling that $500 ashtray thing. Take your Air Force base and let's throw a helicopter like that. And they almost got away with it. But I decided to make a car out of it because everybody relates to the car. Steve the car. And I used to work in a battery factory. I was never out of batteries. Well, I know how it goes. Still got some of them sitting in the garage that 20 years ago. Sell one of them there every now and then and tell me, yeah, it's still good, don't worry about it. And they buy it. We're going to go back to about 1922. Song I wrote. Well, Conway Twitty sung it, that goes to show you how old he is, too. Now, we're going to do this with Granddad right down here in this front row. This is his 80th birthday today. Was it 80 or 90? It was 80, wasn't it? 85. I split the difference with him. 85 years old. This is his birthday. We're going to do this especially for him. This thing is what got me into the music business. My very first record. It was a top 10 record called Wonder Who Will Turn Out the Lights.
Could never Thank you.
mama singing, Rock of Ages couldn't be. She tried to turn me on to Jesus, I turned on to the devil's way. Then I turned out to be the only help my mama ever tried to pay. Then I turned out to be the only help my mom had time to raise.
Back again, and we love y'all because you love country music, and that's where it's at right there. We see some of that other music every now and then on television. We don't hear it though, because I got me one of them things now where you just punch off. I just leave it on and watch them. I can't get used to all them old boys wearing makeup stuff. I noticed that on the Grand Ole Opry, I couldn't hardly believe that. What this world come to?
Doing that breakdown you're
talking about. Doing that breakdown. But we do appreciate it. We're going to go back and get a song. It's an old song. It's written by me, and it was sung by George Jones. And we have to do a George Jones song because we don't owe an awful lot to George, because he got us in the music business. Gave me a job playing guitar, my first job. Fired me next week. Fired me back next morning, though, so that turned out all right. But that was a weekly thing every week I got fired. But he recorded the very first song I ever wrote. First number one I ever had. I feel tears welling up, going deep inside my heart. I'm a big friend.
Somebody who came up to win that moment.
Is that what you're doing? Well, wait on this one. This is a brand new one. You'll have to wait. Now you always do this. We just wrote this. I don't even know this is good yet. But I'm going to try to sing it. We just wrote it. Probably forget some of the words. But I'm going to try to do it. I'll do enough of it to see if y'all like it. If you don't like it, we'll finish. You can see she's the life of the party, and she's happy with her new friends, I can tell. I put her on the top of the bottom, and I'm the reason she's doing so well. She learned everything that I taught her. She's been higher than I've ever been. She drank every bottle that I bought her and kept going when I reached the end. If it wasn't for me, there wouldn't be any party that go on till 1, 2, or 3. If it wasn't for me, she'd be here every time I need her. She wouldn't be there if it wasn't for me. That surprised me. I didn't forget no words. We had a request for a song. The only song I ever wrote in my life was a lie. If you listen to the words of the song real close, I won't explain it. It's called No Man's Land. When she walks through the crowd, all the men, they whisper loud. I know where that they like to go. I know they've all tried, they've all been denied. I know one thing all the men don't know. I just got back from No Man's Land, a place where no man ever laid a hand. Turned up was more than I can stand. I just got back, No Man's Land. One else has ever been there. It's too late for them to go there. The road I took, no man will ever know. Well, I know I am the first one, and I hope I'll be the last one. And I'm proud to be the man she finally chose. I just got back from No Man's Land, place where no man ever laid a hand.
Thank God every day.
They get me like that a lot on stage. They know where I'm at. Got a hidden microphone in there. He's a divorce lawyer out there now. Taping what I said a while ago. They play it back in court. We're going to do a song. There's a lot of these songs that I wrote that I'm stuck on for words. We kind of get all the words mixed up sometimes. Kind of run together when you write a song. But sometimes I'll write a song and I'll wind up making three or four songs. Then they all go back together. It's a mess sometimes, right? But I won't say this because this is a true story about my daddy. Around Fort Smith there where my dad passed away, and I wrote this song especially for him because it is a true story. It's called Daddy's Living Off the Dreams of Mama. Thank you so very much. We really enjoyed playing for y'all one more time. Y'all are a fantastic audience. Good country folks that love country music. The band sounded great. I'm sorry to put all them new songs on you, but y'all didn't even act like it bothered you. So. We missed a note and nobody knew it, did we? We didn't tell them where it was at. And Wendell, we want to thank you so very much for having us back again. And I wish we could have been here with the 4th of July this year. I hear it didn't rain. But we'll be looking forward to coming back again, and thank y'all so very much. We're going to end this show with a song, a gospel song, that I wrote for Conway Twitty as I wanted this new gospel album called Me and My Neighbor. On my way to church one Sunday, I heard my neighbor say, that other church across the street, it don't belong today. Well, they scream and shout and they carry on, but the world's gone in. And I saw him stand in silence as the sermon began. Well, it was my neighbor who stood and listened. While the power of God filled the hearts of everyone. Well, it was my neighbor who kneeled and prayed. Well, it was my neighbor that shouted louder than anyone.
Walk away, baby, leave with my blessing. Once in a while, let me hear from you. If we never meet again before my life is over, I'll leave this world loving you. You can take everything but my memory, but they're good ones and they'll see me through. If we never meet again, I'll love you forever. I'll be this world loving you. You were mine for a time, and I'm thankful, yes I am. But life will be so lonesome without you. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I'm gonna leave this world loving you.
I'm thankful. But life will be so lonesome without you. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I'm gonna leave this world loving you. I'm gonna leave this world.
Neighbors, just listen. When it was my